Hello everyone, this video is in continuation to our videos where we were discussing about human reproduction. Under human reproduction, we have completed till spermatogenesis, we have completed till oogenesis. Oogenesis is done. In this video, we'll start with types of eggs. I'll be discussing the two main types of eggs on the basis of distribution of yolk, on the basis of amount of yolk present. So, watch the video till the end. At the end, you'll get everything on the board. You can note down for the pointers for your notes. Fine. So we'll start with the two types. First of all, I'll divide. One is on the basis of amount of yolk present. Fine. And the other one is on the basis of distribution of yolk. That means how the yolk is distributed in the egg. So we'll start. The first type of egg on the basis of amount of yolk is microlecithal eggs. The second type, or I'll just explain it here first. Microlecithal eggs are the ones which have very less yolk. And the example would be human egg. I have already explained the reason for this, that why humans, they have less amount of yolk. I'll still repeat. Humans, they have less amount of yolk because in humans, the placenta formation will be there. So the nutrients will be transferred from the mother to the fetus. So the amount of yolk, which the function of yolk is to provide nourishment. So the amount of yolk required here is very less. So the eggs which are found in humans are microlecithal. That means have a very less amount of yolk in it. Next is mesolecithal eggs, the eggs which have moderate amount of yolk. They have nahi to they have bahut zyada hai nahi to they have very kam. So they have moderate amount of yolk. The example would be frog's egg. Frog's egg has moderate amount of yolk. That means it has the yolk which will help the developing embryo to develop into a particular stage. Then it will be hatched in a larval stage and will undergo, you know, take nutrition from outside and then will further develop into a fully grown frog. That means the whole nourishment is not provided by the yolk. Yolk is not that much that it could provide a nourishment for the whole development of the structure. So it gives nourishment in the larval stage. Then the organism hatches as a larva and undergoes metamorphosis to form a complete frog. So these type of egg are found in frogs. Then we have the third category, microlecithal, mesolecithal and macrolecithal eggs. Macrolecithal eggs are the eggs which have large amount of yolk. Example found in birds. Now the birds, they have large amount of yolk in it. The egg is hatched and then incubation period is there. The egg is incubated by the hen and finally a chick hatches out, which is a full grown organism. So that means the whole nourishment has to be provided by the yolk. So the amount of yolk present here is in a large amount. Then we'll be talking about the division of the eggs on the basis of the distribution of the yolk. How is yolk distributed in the egg? The first type are homolecithal or isolecithal. That means the yolk is distributed uniformly throughout the distribution is uniform throughout the egg. That means the egg has evenly distributed yolk present in it. This is the type of egg which is homolecule egg, and it is example of human egg. So if I talk, the categories, or which category human egg belongs. So human egg is microlecithal and homolecithal. I am writing in parallel to each one of the categories so that it's easy for you to learn. So the second type of egg on the basis of distribution is a telolecithal. Telolecithal. Doesn't matter. Telolecithal eggs are the ones wherein the yolk is towards one pole or one side. For example, if we see the a hen's egg, what do we observe? That the yolk is present here. It's towards one egg. So the example would be bird's egg, where the yolk is telolecithal, is towards one egg, a side. Next is, we have homolecithal eggs, we have telolecithal eggs, we have centrolecithal eggs then. Centrolecithal eggs. Centrolecithal eggs are wherein the yolk is concentrated towards the center. Yolk is towards the center. Example found in insects. Fine. So these are the different types of eggs. We have microlecithal, mesolecithal, macrolecithal, homolecithal, telolecithal, and centrolecithal. This division is on the basis of amount of yolk, and this is on the basis of distribution of yolk. We have one more category here, the type of eggs which are known as cladoic eggs. Cladoic eggs. Now, what are cladoic eggs? It is a separate term, so I am doing it separately. What are cladoic eggs? The eggs which are self-sufficient. Self-sufficient eggs, for example, eggs of bird. That means they are sufficient enough to give nourishment to the organism so that it can develop to a fully grown organism and then can hatch out. So those type of eggs are known as cladoic eggs. So these are the different types of eggs on the basis of yolk distribution, on the basis of amount of yolk, and cladoic eggs, the eggs which are self-sufficient. So in our next video, we'll be talking about the difference between egg and sperm. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.